Statistics show that the majority of Americans believe that the Earth is extremely old, on the order of millions or billions of years. Why do they believe that? Well, no doubt it's because they've been told by the scientific community that the Earth is that old. But why does the scientific community believe the Earth is that old? Well, many scientists believe in an old Earth because they believe there are several evidences that support that belief, like radioisotope dating techniques, how much time it would take to erode canyons like the Grand Canyon, how long it would take to petrify a tree or bone, turning it to stone, how long it would take for the material found in the rock layers to build up, how long it would take for coal and oil to form in the age of diamonds, how long it would take for the ice layers in Greenland and Antarctica to build up, how long it would take for the varves that are found in lakes to build up, how long it would take to form the thousands of rings found in living and petrified trees, how long it would take light to get here from stars that are billions of light years away from us, how long it would take for caves to form, how long it would take for mountains to form, how long it would take to move the continents from Pangaea to their current positions. No doubt, that definitely sounds like a lot of evidence. Does the evidence prove that the Earth is millions or billions of years old? Well, no, and here's why. Every single one of those examples are based on a basic assumption, which, if it's wrong, causes all the examples to be removed from the list of evidences of an old Earth. The assumption is called uniformitarianism, the belief that we can look at the geological processes that are happening on the Earth today and project our observations back in time to figure out what happened on the Earth in the past based on what we see today. Uniformitarianism assumes that only things happening today happened in the past. Features of the Earth that we see today had to be formed by processes that we observe today. The assumption is that there never have been unusual or even supernatural events in the past which don't happen today, but which could have in the past sped up processes that we see happening slowly today. If those processes were faster in the past, then the features that were made by those processes are much younger than they appear. But each of these processes assume uniformitarianism. For instance, radioisotope dating techniques assume that nuclear decay rates have stayed the same as they are today throughout history, even though there are recent evidences that disprove that assumption. Canyon erosion evidences assume that canyons have always eroded away at the same rates that they do today, even though we have many evidences of catastrophic events which have eroded canyons rapidly. Petrification is assumed to have always happened slowly and gradually as it is thought to do today, even though many recent studies have shown that catastrophic rather than uniform activity speeds the petrification process up. Stratification, the buildup of materials that become the rock layers of the geologic column, is assumed to have happened slowly over millions of years since sediment accumulation is so slow today. But volcanic eruptions, mudslides from flooding, and polystrate fossils have shown that strata can be built quickly. Coal, oil, and diamonds are assumed to have needed millions of years to form, since modern processes seem to require that. But again, recent studies have showed that that assumption is false. The circumstances for the rapid formation of coal have been shown to be present after volcanic activity. Oil forms rapidly, both naturally and in laboratories. And diamonds have been found with carbon-14 in them, proving that they're only a few thousand years old. Tree ring studies assume that only one tree ring forms every year, as is the case today, but scientists have discovered that unusual weather circumstances can cause more than one ring to form each year, the very weather circumstances which would be predicted to be the case during the ice age after the flood. Starlight from stars that are billions of light years away is assumed to have traveled to the Earth at the speed of light, as it seems to be doing today, and yet various evidences suggest light might not have traveled here naturally. If starlight was created supernaturally, for example, obviously, it wouldn't have traveled to Earth in the normal, natural way it does today. As is the case with the formation of tree rings, Ice core layers are assumed to form annually, one layer per year. But once again, evidence from the past several years has shown that ice core layering can form sub-annually when irregular weather patterns are present, again, like the conditions we'd predict to be the case during the post-flood ice age. Similarly, Lake Varve buildup is assumed to be at the rate of one varve per year in lakes, but volcanic eruptions and the conditions from the ice age can cause varves to build up faster. It's true that mountain formation is very slow today, but that's because the Earth's tectonic plates are moving at a slow pace today. But there's mounting evidence that the plates move much faster in the past, which would cause the mountains to form faster and would decrease how much time was necessary to move the continents to their current position. Cave formation is assumed to have taken tens of thousands of years or more in some cases, because it would take so long for weak carbonic acid to seep down through the ground to the cave and slowly dissolve the limestone that then makes up many of these caves, and then hundreds to thousands of years added on to that for the formation of the speleothems like stalactites and stalagmites after the cave forms. Once again, uniformitarianism is assumed in such calculations. More and more evidence is being discovered that suggests that caves have been dissolved quickly from sulfuric acid instead of slowly from carbonic acid. And sulfuric acid would have been abundant during the flood due to the heavy volcanic activity and bacterial activity. The rate of the formation of speleothems in caves is assumed to have always been at the slow rate we see today, about 1 inch per century. But higher levels of rain than we see today, a different surface air temperature, and a higher drip rate, droplet concentration, and carbon dioxide levels in the soil increases the speed that speleothems grow, and each of those factors would have been significant during the post-flood ice age. Once the assumption of uniformitarianism is dropped, each of these so-called evidences of an old Earth disappear. When catastrophic activity is taken into account, catastrophic activity associated with the flood, the post-flood ice age, and even catastrophic events that happen today. The ages of mountains, rock layers, starlight, the polar ice caps, lakes, coal, oil, diamonds, caves, canyons, fossils, radioactive rocks, and trees, they all plummet, falling into the biblical time frame. There's absolutely no scientific reason to believe that the Earth is millions or billions of years old. There's no reason to believe that its age isn't exactly what the Bible implies it to be, 6,000 to 8,000 years old. In fact, there's every reason to believe that it is as young as the Bible claims, since we can know from the evidence that the Bible is inspired by God, which means it's true, and therefore it can be trusted in its claims about the young age of the Earth. For more information, be sure to check out our website at apologeticspress.org.